So is it possible to film yourself and make it look like you have multiple cameras, like you have multiple angles, like you have a crew, like you have other people working with you and it's not just you? Is it possible to do that? I say yes. I actually just shot a whole film by myself on my phone. And I think if you just use some common sense and if you really, really kind of work it out and think about the way things should look naturally to the world, if you really think like a filmmaker and think in terms of your story, how you want to express yourself visually, you can definitely shoot yourself, make a film about you, with you, as the only person in the film, like most people do with YouTube videos, and you could do it all by yourself and make it look like you have a whole bunch of cameras, a whole bunch of people, a professional crew. You can do it all by yourself. So I went out the other day and I wanted to shoot. I was feeling kind of solitary, and I'm kind of a solitary guy anyway. I'm a solo theater artist. I do a lot of stuff on my own. But I was really especially feeling kind of detached, and I wanted to express myself visually like that. I wanted to somehow evoke those kind of feelings in a short kind of video montage, or a short film, maybe some people would call it. I don't really consider it that, but anyway, I wanted to express it. So I just went to some random places, like three or four different places around where I live. And I kind of thought about the specific locations that I thought would be good for this. And I also thought about which lenses I would use, because I'm obsessed with lenses and the spiritual nature of how they can really affect the emotional impact of what you're trying to shoot. So for most of this, I just wanted it to look like real life. So I used my Sony 35mm f1.8 OSS lens, because that lens doesn't really bring any distortion to the picture at all. But I also wanted to add some feeling of like being alone amidst the big world, you know what I mean? And so I decided to use my Samyang 12mm f2, which is an ultra-wide angle lens, and place myself in a situation where you could just see this one solitary person out there in this gigantic world. I think a wide-angle lens expresses that the best. Now, obviously, the entire montage is just me alone in these different areas, but I think as it progresses, I become more and more isolated in a kind of ironic way, because I'm out in the streets among people, but you don't see a whole lot of people. But, you know, it's not like I'm in back alleys or anything like that. I'm out in the streets, in the world. I did find some abandoned buildings, an abandoned restaurant, because I felt like abandonment was a good kind of metaphor for what I was feeling as well. And I think I wanted to share it because I think it's a good example of how you can actually create something that looks like you really had to go get a crew of people to help you. So basically, I'm not going to get into all the technical aspects of everything, but obviously you have to make sure that things are consistent in terms of your exposure, the location, obviously. But the thing that you really have to think about is you have to think about the flow from shot to shot. Like, for example, if you're walking in front of a building, say, if you end your first shot in front of a certain window, like a specific window, that second shot should begin where you left off the first shot. And the other thing you need to think about is, let's say that you're walking and you can see my whole body. You know, you can see your whole body. Try to emulate the step, you know, try to continue the stepping that you're doing. In other words, if my right foot is about to hit the ground when I cut, maybe the first moment of the second cut is that foot hitting the ground. And so it's a consistent kind of rhythm. You know, that's the other thing, is I work in rhythm, you know, like the other thing is this, it's really interesting. Obviously, if you have a whole lot of cameras, you can just work with one take, and then you can take all these cameras' perspectives, the different angles that they're shooting at, and cut it all together. But you have one seamless take, so it's kind of easy to put them together. But obviously, doing it the way that I do it, I have to do all separate takes. You know, like I have to do the same motion four or five times to have four or five shots. So I need to make sure that I try to simulate the same thing each time that I do it. You know, I try to do the same amount of steps. I have to look in the same direction. I have to move my body in the same way. I have to hope that the sun stays the same. You know, if I wanted to really, really be specific, I mean, I don't think you really have to be that meticulous with it, but I think you have to intend to be that. Like, you have to be meticulous in your work, even though the universe, the world out here, does not have to participate fully and completely for it to look good. But the closer, the better, obviously. Like, if all the conditions stay the same, then it looks better when you cut it all together. But I think that your approach has to be really, really specific, and you have to really plan it out, and you really have to use your imagination, you know, planning the shots. You know, you might have one shot from behind, and then you have another shot coming toward the camera, but it's the same motion. You might have a shot if you're in front of a building looking at the building, and then you maybe have a shot maybe from the perspective of somebody looking out a window as you pass by. You have some low angle shots. Maybe you put the camera in a tree and have a higher angle shot. That's the other thing. You know, because I shot a movie on my phone, I had a lot of flexibility with where I could put my camera, which was my phone. It was small. So I could put it between rock, you know, like rocks on a rock wall. I could put it under a car. I could put it anywhere. And I've been doing the same thing with my camera. That's one thing I really love about the Sony a6400. It's so small, I could put it anywhere. And so it gets pretty dirty sometimes because I don't always use my tripod, because sometimes I want it to be on the ground. You know, sometimes I want to put it up in a tree. So I think you really have to be creative with where you place it. You know, be careful with your equipment, definitely. Don't, you know, don't mess up your stuff. But also, don't be so delicate with it. You know, the whole point is to get the best shot, to tell the best story. And so what I'm doing all the time is really practicing for, you know, the stories that I tell. Like, I'm working on a new movie right now. And so I am experimenting with light, with lenses, with focal distance, you know, with everything, you know, with where I place the camera, with angles, and with my editing. I'm constantly working on my editing to make it better, because if I'm shooting by myself, my editing has to be really, really on point for it to look normal and for it to not get in the way of the story, because you don't want it to, like, you know, take people out of the story because they're noticing that you have these jump cuts and things like that. You want it to be more like they go, oh my God, you shot that by yourself? Like, how's that even possible? If you can get to that, then you've done your job. So anyway, I'm not going to explain too much more because I'm not really the technical guy, but I think you maybe understand what I'm saying. And what I'm going to do now is just play the montage that I shot the other day, just random places, no dialogue, no nothing. I'm going to use some music from a Billie Eilish song, which means that if I ever get to the point where I can monetize my channel, I will never be able to monetize this particular video. But a funny story is that I edited this video before I used any music. I just cut it all together because I was just working on the transitions. And I just felt like this Billie Eilish song would sound so good over this video that I created, you know, this short little film. And when I put it on there, the distance, you know, the length of the song was exactly the length of the cut that I made. And you'll see it ends at the exact same time. So I was like, how can I not keep that, you know? So if I ever get it monetized, I won't be able to monetize this video. Credit to Billie Eilish. She's amazing. And I hope you enjoy the video. And I hope this makes sense to you. And I hope it helps. And I hope to see you on the next one. And please subscribe to my channel if you like what I do. And hit the like button if you like this video. And I'll see you next time. So enjoy the montage. Thanks for listening. Say I like it like that, like
like it like that. Like it like, say I like it like that. Like it like that.
Say I like it like that, like it like that.